Assalamu alaikum. I am your social teacher from Nadir Public School, Tandoor. Welcome to Social Subject Class 5th. Students, our chapter name is The Treeless Grasslands. Students, in previous class we discussed about grassland. I hope you remember what is grassland. Now let us revise, okay? So, grassland area in which the vegetation is dominated by a nearly continuous cover of grasses. Grasslands occur in environments conducive to the growth of this plant cover but not to that of taller plants, particularly trees and shrubs. The factors preventing establishment of such taller woody vegetation are varied. Okay. So, students, grasslands are one of the most widespread of all the major vegetation types of the world. This is so, however, only because human manipulation of the land has significantly altered the natural vegetation, creating artificial grasslands of cereal crops, pastures, and other areas that require some form of repetitious unnatural disturbance such as cultivation, heavy grazing, burning or moving to persist. Students, in this class we will discuss about prairie. Okay. Students, prairie are ecosystems considered part of the temperate grasslands, savannas and shrublands biome by ecologists based on similar temperate climates, moderate rainfall and a composition of grasses, herbs and shrubs rather than trees as the dominant vegetation type. Students, temperate grassland regions include the pampas of Argentina, Brazil and Uruguay and the steppe of Ukraine, Russia and Kazakhstan. Lands typically referred to as prairie tend to be in North America. The term encompasses the area referred to as the interior lowlands of Canada, the United States and Mexico, which includes all of the Great Plains as well as the wetter hiller land to the east. Okay. Students, you know, in the US, the area is constituted by most or all of the states of North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Kansas, and Oklahoma, and sizable parts of the states of Montana, Wyoming, Colorado, New Mexico, Texas, Missouri, Iowa, Illinois, Indiana, Wisconsin, and western and southern Minnesota. The plains of Washington and the Central Valley of California are also prairies. The Canadian prairies occupy vast areas of Manitoba, Saskatchewan, and Alberta. Okay? Students, you know the formation of the North American prairies started with the uplift of the Rocky Mountains near Alberta. The mountains created a rain shadow that resulted in lower precipitation rates downwind. Students, the parent material of most prairie soil was distributed during the last glacial advance that began about 110,000 years ago. The glaciers expanding southward scraped the landscape, picking up geologic material and leveling the terrain. As the glaciers retreated about 10,000 years ago, it deposited this material in the form of till. Wind-based loess deposits also form an important parent material for prairie soils. Okay? Students, in spite of long recurrent droughts and occasional torrential rains, the grasslands of the Great Plains were not subject to great soil erosion. The root systems of native prairie grasses firmly held the soil in place to prevent runoff of soil. When the plant died, the fungi and bacteria returned its nutrients to the soil. These deep roots also helped native prairie plants reach water in even the driest conditions. Native grasses suffered much less damage from dry conditions than many farm crops currently grown. Okay? Students, now today's class is over. I hope you understand my class. Now see your assessment. Answer the following questions. Question number 1. Describe the vegetation in the prairies. Answer. There are no big trees in the prairies. The prairies have thick grasses. The grasses are short or tall depending on the amount of rainfall. Okay. Question number 2. How do prairie dogs help plants? Answer. Prairie dogs turn the soil over when they dig their burrows. This helps plants. Okay. Thank you so much, students, for listening to my class.